As a golf instructor, I know this. One of the easiest ways for people to lower their golf scores is to improve their chipping. But I also know it's one of the most confusing things, and quite honestly, one of the things in golf that is just not taught correctly. Well, here's the good news. Today, I'm going to share with you the key component to hitting good quality chip shots and lowering your scores. I'm PGA teaching professional Todd Kolb, Director of Instruction for US Golf TV and the Sanford Power Golf Academy. And my most favorite thing to teach in golf is chipping, because basically when you understand a couple key concepts, the results come almost immediately. So today I want to talk a little bit about maybe the mistake you're making and just kind of open up your eyes a little bit, educate you a little bit on how we can just simply change that and hit some better chip shots. So we've done a ton of videos already on chipping. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe because we got some great content coming out. Or also be sure to leave a comment. If you got a question on what I'm talking about here today, or maybe you disagree or agree, that's fine. Either way, we love hearing from you. Be sure to leave a comment. So here's the first thing you need to know about chipping. If you want to hit good quality chip shots, you have to have what we call effective loft. So let's define that. All right, then we're going to talk a little bit about what you might be doing in the motion that's taking that loft away and what type of shots you're seeing. And then last but not least, I'm going to give you a simple key checkpoint that's going to fix it immediately. So effective loft is this. This club here, I got my Volke wedge. I love these Volke wedges. It's 56 degrees, all right, 56 degrees. Meaning when the club is in a neutral position, it has 56 degrees of loft. Now, loft is your friend, folks. When you're chipping, loft is good. It makes the shot easier. We do not want to do things that de-loft the golf club, all right? Don't do that, all right? Because it just makes the shot more difficult. So here's the mistake that you might be making when you're chipping. Now, I'm not going to go through all the setup stuff. If you got questions on the setup, check out some of our other content. We've got some great videos where we go through in detail how you set up to hit a quality chip shot. So I'm going to assume you know that already. So when you're in here, here's the mistake that I guarantee you're probably making if you're not chipping the ball well. When you're taking the club away, the club head starts to work too far inside, what I call around and inside. Now, two things happen when the club works inside. The first one is when the club works inside and the handle stays out here, the bottom of the swing, or what we call the low point, the bump point, basically where the club wants to come in contact with the ground, moves backwards. All right, so that's the first thing you need to know. When you take the club back and you drag it inside, the bottom of the swing works backwards. So what types of shots might you see? Well, if you chunk a lot of shots, if you top a lot of chip shots, all right, if you just struggle with contact, that could be wise. I guarantee it's something that very few people think about, but it's something I see on a daily basis. So that's number one. Number two, remember we talked about this effective loft. All right, so the loft is when the butt end of the club right here and the club head are in the same neutral position. This club now, all right, has 56 degrees of loft on it right here, okay? But when the club head works backwards and the handle works forward, all right, now I have de-lofted the golf club, all right? So what happens? Well, here's usually what I experience, is that when somebody takes the club and they drag it inside, the bottom of the swing works backwards, we know that, but they've really de-lofted the golf club. You can see that right there. It's de-lofted. So what do? Well, instinctively, what they do is they speed the club head up because they know they've got to get back to neutral because they need that loft. If they don't, if they just keep pulling through, they're going to hit shots super low. So what do? They speed the club head up. Now, how would you know if you're doing that? Well, because you might hit a shot and you're like, God, that felt really solid. It felt like great contact, but it just runs off and goes crazy. It's what that shot is hot. When you hit a good chip shot, it should land and be soft and roll out like a putt. All right, so those are the two things that I see that I want you to look at if you're struggling with your chipping. Take a look when the club head goes back. If it's dragging too far inside, you might be struggling with contact, or you might hit shots that are solid contact, but they're just hot. All right, hopefully that's making sense. Now, if not, be sure to leave a comment if you want me to explain that better or differently. I'd be happy to do that. Or maybe you disagree with something that I've said there. That's fine as well too. So what are you going to do to fix that? All right, that's what you're here for, right? How do I fix it? Well, here's the one key tip that I guarantee is going to improve your chipping. I've given this to anybody from a new golfer who's never played golf to literally tour professionals. It's helped them every single time. All right, so here's the tip. You've got the butt end of the club. You've got the club head. The key is this, okay? Listen carefully. when you move the club away from the golf ball, the butt end of the club and the club head have to work the same direction initially. So you'll notice when I'm set in here, the butt end of the club and the club head move the same direction. That's the key component. Now, the club head is traveling further than the butt end of the club. We're not going to dive into all that stuff. Okay, all right. That's for another discussion. But when the butt end of the club and the club head work the same direction, then you maintain those key components of that effective loft that we've already discussed. Most people, if they struggle with their chipping, do this. The butt end of the club goes towards the target. The club head works away from the target. Okay, that is a death move for chipping. Do not do that, all right? When the butt end goes that way, the club head goes this way, we've got a lot of problems, all right? So let's recap what we've learned here today. When you evaluate your chip shots, they should be soft. They should land and roll out like a putt. They should not be hot, all right? If you're struggling with contact, you could be simply dragging the club inside, all right? And that moves the bottom of the swing backwards. If you hit shots, you're like, that's pretty solid, but it just goes too darn far. That's your way of like probably taking it inside and then working back to neutral. And when you accelerate that club head really fast, the ball takes off. The key tip to fixing all that, very simple. When you're set in there, take the butt end of the club head, move them the same direction. If you do that, I guarantee it's gonna definitely improve your chipping. So hey, hopefully that helps you out a little bit. We got a little long-winded on this one, but we wanted to dive deep into this and really help you improve your chipping. Be sure to leave a comment. Be sure to subscribe if you like what we said or you don't like what we said. I love hearing it. I try to respond to all of those. And be sure to check back because we, on a regular basis, are providing the best content we can to help you enjoy this wonderful game and shoot lower scores. I was rambling, I thought. Move through some of these things that we're talking about. So, sorry. I liked the beginning and then I didn't like the one part there. Well, the thing is that you have to, sorry. What are we at? How long are we at? I wanted to get into it a little bit quicker.
Yeah.
Not bad, I guess.